So welcome back. In the last lecture we were doing the applications of residue, and I think in this also we will be doing the same, but the application this time we will be doing is previously we have done some integrations.
Okay,
we have seen that how integrations are can be solved using this residue. So in this we will be using the residue application over series. So how can we solve the series using this residue?
Okay,
so what we will be doing, so we will be using, we will be doing summation of series.
Okay,
summation of series using residue. So in this using the summation of series using residue. So there are many type of series.
Okay,
so basically what we will be seeing is a summation of a series like this one.
Okay,
minus infinity to infinity, and let the sum summation be over summation is definitely over n.
Okay,
so n is varying from minus infinity to infinity, and some function of n is here, and so we have to find the summation of this series. So what will be this, so what will be the value of this, and how we will be using, how we will be solving this using the residue. So we will be seeing that. So the formula for this one definitely we will be seeing the formula only, because if you see the proof it's it will be pretty hodgepodge. So we will be using the formula. So the formula for this is, let's understand this. The formula for the formula is negative of,
okay,
so this is negative of sum of residues.
Okay,
sum of residues. So in the previous the integrals also we used the sum of residues, but we multiplied that thing by 2 pi i. So let's see what we are doing this in. So sum of residues of pi cot pi z multiplied by fz. Okay, so what is this fz? This fn.
Okay,
so when n replaced by z, this will be fz. So the same fn and the same fz. So this is the summation of series using residue. So we will be how we will be using this. So let's see. So for better we so first let me tell you that this fz is multiplied with this cot pi z, and this is pi.
Okay,
and we will be taking the residues. So residues, whatever the residues of this function, this whole, if I say this is gz.
Okay,
so this is a function of z, so we can call this whole as a gz. Then we have to find the residues of this, and we have to make the sum of the residues.
Okay,
so here I have a problem with you. No, actually I have a problem with on this topic. So let's see how we can solve this summation. So it's a pretty brilliant summation, you can see.
Okay, so is every summation we can solve using residue?
Definitely not. The first the only restriction on this is the summation should be converging.
Okay,
the summation should be converging, then only we can solve this. Oh my god, my handwriting is improving a lot. Pretty happy with this. So the summation of the series, so series should be converging, then only you can use this. And this limit you can see minus infinity to plus infinity. So we can apply on this, because definitely this is a converging series.
Okay,
and let's see what will be the value of this. So firstly define fz.
Okay,
firstly define fz. So what will be fz? So fz will be, so fz will be, you can see replace n by z, so it will be z square plus a square.
Okay,
and for gz,
okay,
so for let me make the gz. So for gz you have to multiply this by pi, then multiply this by cot pi z. I hope you got it, no problem in this. So we have got gz. And what I need to do is find the residues.
Okay,
so firstly before finding the residue, what we need,
बिफोर फाइंडिंग द रेसिड्यू. सो वो फर्स्ट वी नीड पोल्स. सो फर्स्ट वी नीड पोल्स. इट्स नॉट लाइक माई हैंड राइटिंग इज इम्प्रूव सो आई एम राइटिंग इट इज डोंट अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग. ओके सो बिफोर फाइंडिंग द रेसिड्यू वी फर्स्ट नीड टू फाइंड पोल्स. एंड वाट इज द पोल्स? सो यू कैन गेट दैट बाई जेड स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर मेकिंग दैट जीरो. एंड फॉर द रिजल्ट द सोल्यूशन विल बी जेड प्लस माइनस आई ए. ओके सो दिस विल बी द पोल्स. ओके दिस विल बी द पोल्स. एंड वट आई कैन से अबाउट दिस जी जेड दैट दिस इज अ सिंपल पोल. ओके दिस यू कैन सी दिस बोथ आर देर आर टू पोल्स एक्चुअली. ओके देर आर टू पोल्स. सो वन इज जेड प्लस आई ए एंड अनदर इज जेड माइनस आई ए. ओके सो दीज आर टू पोल्स एंड बोथ आर सिंपल बिकॉज बोथ हैव ऑर्डर वन. सो यू कैन ईजिली फाइंड द रेसिड्यूज ऑफ दिस वन. ओके सो फर्स्टली इफ यू नीड टू फाइंड द रेसिड्यूज. सो इफ यू लेट्स से इफ यू टू फाइंड द रेसिड्यूज एट वन ऑफ दिस पोल्स. लेट्स से द पोल इज लेट्स यू टू फाइंड द रेसिड्यू एट रेसिड्यू इफ यू नीड टू फाइंड एट जेड इज इक्वल टू आई ए. ओके सो रेसिड्यू एट जेड इज इक्वल टू आई ए हाउ कैन यू गेट दैट? सो फॉर दैट मल्टीप्लाई बाई दिस जेड माइनस आई ए. सो मल्टीप्लाई जेड माइनस आई ए विथ जी जेड एंड यूज द लिमिट जेड टेंस टू आई ए. ओके सो दिस इज प्रेटी सिंपल. सो अप्लाइंग द सेम थिंग लिमिट जेड टेंडिंग टू आई ए एंड दिस पाई कॉट पाई जेड दिस जेड माइनस आई ए मल्टीप्लाइड सो दैट विल बी कैंसल. वॉट विल बी लेफ्ट विथ इज जेड प्लस आई ए. ओके सो सिंपली पुट दैट वैल्यू वॉट विल बी गेटिंग विल बी गेटिंग पाई कॉट पाई आई पाई ए. ओके एंड टू आई ए. सो दिस इज द थिंग यू विल बी गेटिंग. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द रेसिड्यू. सो अनदर रेसिड्यू विल ऑल्सो बी देयर. सो लेट मी स्लाइड इट डाउन लिटिल बिट. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द रेसिड्यू. एंड वॉट विल बी द नेक्स्ट रेसिड्यू? सो द नेक्स्ट रेसिड्यू विल बी फॉर जेड इज इक्वल टू माइनस आई ए. सो लेट मी राइट दैट डायरेक्टली. सो दिस टाइम विल बी गेटिंग लिमिट जेड टेंस टू माइनस आई ए इफ यू अप्लाई. सो वी विल बी लेफ्ट विथ पाई कॉट पाई जेड. सो आई वॉज हैविंग अ स्पीच आई स्टॉप्ड इट. ओके सो वॉट वी वर डूइंग पाई कॉट पाई जेड जेड प्लस आई ए. ओके सो जेड प्लस दिस टाइम जेड प्लस आई विल बी कैंसल. सो वॉट वी विल लेफ्ट विथ जेड माइनस आई ए. सो दैट विल बी माइनस टू आई ए. ओके सो लेट मी राइट इट जेड माइनस आई ए. सो वॉट विल बी लेफ्ट विथ इज पाई कॉट पाई जेड ओवर जेड माइनस आई. ओहो आई शुडंट हैव डन दिस. आई शुड हैव यूज दिस वन. आई शुड हैव यूज जेड इज इक्वल टू माइनस पाई आई आई ए. ओके सो वॉट विल बी लेफ्ट विथ माइनस टू आई ए. आई डोंट थिंक एनी प्रॉब्लम इज देयर. ओके and this pi cot pi z is minus i a. okay so pi minus pi okay so this is a minus pi I a divided by minus 2 I a. okay so this cot minus will be coming out and this minus will be cancelled. so what will be left with is pi cot पाई आई ए ओवर टू आई ए. सो यू कैन सी द बोथ द रिजल्ट आर सेम. ओके सो दिस वन एंड दिस वन. सो बोथ द रेसिड्यूज आर द सेम. सो आई डोंट थिंक एनी ट्रबल इज देयर. ओके यू कैन फर्दर सिंप्लीफाई दिस कॉट आई पाई ए. सो यू कैन राइट दिस कॉट आई पाई ए you can write this as cot hyperbolic phi a. Okay, so so I hope there is minus I also coming out. Okay, so minus I also will be coming out. So what will be okay, so let me create some space, let me slide it down. Okay, so we have got the two residues. Oh, I can't have to change the color. First let me do this. Okay, so cot I pi a, cot pi okay, so these both are the same. So we got sum of residues, so minus times sum of residues. Sum of residues will be cot I pi a, can be written as minus I times cot hyperbolic pi a. Okay, so that will be okay, so you can do this anytime, you can write this. So let me do this here only. So I can write as pi cot pi a, I can write as minus I cot h pi a, and this 2 I a. Okay, so this I and minus I will be cancelled to give a minus. Okay, so what I will be written left as minus 2 times this residue, because both are the same. So I will be writing minus pi cot h pi a by 2 a. Okay, so this minus minus will be cancelled, so the result will be 2 pi cot h pi a by 2 a. So this will be the result. So we should see some more problems. So let me change the page to get some more problems. So what we will be doing, so the topic of this will be more problems on summation, more problems. So one more similar problem is there. I will be writing that problem. So that is 1 over n square plus a square, the summation. Okay, but the limit is this time 1 to infinity. So in such cases what we'll be doing, so the limit is not minus infinity to infinity. So the limit is not minus infinity to infinity, but minus infinity to infinity. So better write this as fn. Fn is 1 upon, so fn is 1 over n square plus a square. Okay, so this you can write as minus infinity to minus 1 fn plus f at 1. Okay, so one lift and plus you can write as summation. So up to minus 1 we have covered. Okay, so 0 you have to cover, and then from 1 to infinity you can cover. So this will be whole infinity, minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay, so this is the way you can write this one as. So you have to basically find this limit. Okay, this one is the same as this one. You can I hope there is no problem understanding that, because if you replace fn by minus f minus n. Okay, so this is an even function. So what will be the, this integral will be summation, the limits will be reversed. Okay, so infinity to 1. Okay, and this f n and f minus n will both are same. Okay, whether you take minus n a whole square or n a square, both will be the same. So these both sums, these both are the same. So you can better write, minus infinity to infinity as 2 times summation 1 to infinity. Okay, so these both are the same, so I have written as together, combine them, and lastly f0. So what will be f0? F0 is pretty simple. F0 will be put the 0 here, so it will be, so f0 will be 1 over a square. So minus infinity say infinity. Oh, so minus here plus here, doesn't matter whether you write this way or that way. So this one you have find out just in the previous page you had find out this thing. Okay. No, you have found out this thing. Okay. So this is the problem which is asked in this one, plus 1 by a square. Okay. So this thing you know from the previous problem. What was that? I don't remember. So better subtract 1 by a square that side, and you will be getting 2 times this. So and divide by 2. So you will be getting as so this thing. So this thing will be 1 by 2 times summation of minus infinity to infinity f n minus 1 by a square. So this is the result. So this thing you know, put the value and you will be getting the answer. So if the limits are not given, so you can solve the problem in this way. So I think these two problems are enough to understand the way how it solves, and I don't think any more is required. You can solve by you can take some problems and solve it by your own. So basically you don't have to do anything extraordinary. Okay, so you don't have to do too much in this summation problem. Just find the fz, which is very simple to find the fz. Okay, and the rest is multiply this by cot pi z. Okay, so this thing you get, this thing you know, and just multiply this by pi. So these three things are simply available in the problem, and just find the residues of this one. Okay, so find the residues. So just understand this as another function gz, and find out the residues of this function. Okay, so once you know the residues of this function, just sum the residues, and take a minus over take a minus out. So that is the way to solve this summations from this residue.